caught me off guard.
She's so honey.
So, I really like the beer.
Yo, what's up, guys? My name's Emerson. This is my business partner, Rob. Today, we jump in this Scion right here, head on down to Vista, California to check out Belching Beaver. Welcome to the Sawse.
The name is Hangar 24.
So I met up with Rob. We're on our way down to Escondido. Who's the contact? Who's your rep? Not Haley, but...
Cesar.
Okay, so Rob got a hold of Cesar. Cesar contacted Haley. Haley is our contact at...
Belching Beaver.
Belching Beaver. You got a lot to say now. Haley's a contact at Belching Beaver. Apparently they don't open until 4:30, but we're getting in contact with Haley, and then she's going to let us in to get the private tour. So see you guys down there. So from what we understand, this is a new location. We're gonna see if we can check it out. This is Haley. Haley, what are you here?
I'm the marketing manager here at Belching Beaver Brewery.
Haley's gonna show us around a little bit and get a little tour of the place. Go from there. Cool. All right, so show us how to brew.
Yeah, right.
Come on.
Well, you just hit this button here. All right.
Is this the dog toy?
Yeah. He's all over the place.
So these guys are installing a new centrifuge to make the beer clear, so all the particulates inside the beer clear out. So that thing, that machine is responsible for clearing that itself out. So how often do you bottle?
We bottle Monday through Thursday. We have a commanding line that comes in every Wednesday.
So Haley just poured us a couple of miso honeys, which is what we're drinking tonight. So she's going to get one of the head brewers and have him come over here and talk to us about the beer. So they've been in this facility for about 8 months or so, really built it out well, looks really nice. They just put the tap room in, did a really good job here, beer tastes good. We'll see what the head brewer has to say. Him. There he is. Not too shabby. I've got to know, did the name come from Full Metal Jacket?
Of course.
It did.
I'm sure it did.
That's the actual helmet from Full Metal Jacket.
Really? Economy of scales, you know, it takes us 10 hours to brew 120 barrels of beer here. Yeah. It takes us 10 hours to brew 30 barrels of beer at our own facility. So yeah. it's just huge, huge difference.
So So we've tried the miso honey so far, and what was this one called?
Coconut pineapple IPA.
Both really good.
Just went through a rebrand, so this is all of our new packaging.
Thank you, guys.
Yep. Thanks, man. Appreciate it.
Appreciate it, brother. Have a good one.
All right. You too. We're going to pick up some shirts for the girls at the shop and ourselves. And we're going to let Haley get back to work. We're going to let you get back to work, actually. I'm sure we've taken up plenty of your time.
Yeah.
So anyways, guys, I want to say thank you to Haley over here. She has been amazing as far as the hospitality goes. So thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Have fun.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Come out our way.
Thank you. Well, we're done over here at Belching Beaver. Let's tip one back over to Cesar.
Hey, it's not Cesar, but it's the next best thing, right? He's outside. I'm gonna grab Rob, grab Cesar, talk to him, see what the heck's going on with this beer. And just get some insight, get some information on Belching Beaver. Hopefully you guys enjoy. All right, let's go grab Cesar.
The hero of that story was afraid to let this power fall into the hands of an immature mankind. And so he chose rather to destroy.
What's up?
Right now,
like, we post them online.
Yeah.
So we're just supplying like our customers with some inside information.
I saw you guys on Snapchat and I saw a little bit of the blurt with the little. That
was did you see? Yeah. I did. I take those videos and then I edit them.
Yeah.
Then I re-import them and then I have to break them down into 15-second intervals so that we can.
That's pretty cool. I was like, oh man, I'm showing my
wife.
Check this out.
That's cool.
Right on. All right. So, sweet. I didn't even have to ask. Now that's service.
Yeah.
Cheers. So we're at Pint Night at Stackz. We just got back from the brewery. We've got Cesar here. We're going to ask him a few questions. So, Cesar.
How are you guys doing? We're here representing Belching Beaver. We got the miso honey on tap. It's a 5.5 honey blonde ale. Honey sourced out of San Diego, wildflowers. And we've got a couple locations down there in San Diego. If you guys are ever in the area, come try some pints down here at Stackz. And cheers.
Right on. Belching Beaver, they have a bar and grill too, right?
Yes. Yeah. We got a bar and grill in Vista, downtown Vista.
Yeah.
We've got full alcohol service, food, and a variety of our beers. On top of that, we got a lot of guest beers that we put on, kind of test the market, see what's out there, see what's moving. And that's kind of what gauges us to put the beers on the market to what's already kind of proven to sell.
Right on.
So that's definitely what we use that. A lot of great food. One of our five locations down in San Diego. Absolutely. Yeah.
Right on. So, cool.
Yeah, yeah.
What I noticed when I went down to Belching Beaver, it seemed like a family orientated, close knit. Everybody was so helpful. Haley down there, when we got down, I mean, you got us in contact with Haley.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
She was amazing down there.
Cool.
I mean, just they hooked us up, got us some beers, let us try a bunch of stuff, let us tour the factory or the brewery.
Sure.
All that stuff. It was cool.
Awesome. So, yeah. No, that's I'm glad, we're able to accommodate that too. You know, we don't open until a little later, but I figured, we got some people down there. It's a great operation we got going now. So I figure, we'd like to, especially for outside the territory, most people hear about us out here, but they don't know what we really got going out there. And with all the new innovation, just adding a centrifuge this week. So
we were there when they were installing it.
Awesome.
Yeah.
So you'll start to see a little bit of the clarity in the IPAs that we're pouring and stuff. So
we actually talked about it a little bit on camera, on
awesome.
Film.
Cool.
So
cool. Yeah.
Kind of let everybody know.
Cool, man. It's definitely a family atmosphere. That's one of the main reasons I like coming in, is because I kind of came from that. I feel like breweries, that's a big thing between the communal part of that is, just kind of not, it's not all about us. It's about the craft beer. And we definitely represent that out there a little bit. So I think that's, that's all part of the family atmosphere of it. So,
gotcha.
Yeah,
gotcha.
Yeah. We're real independent right now to the point where,
You know, we try to, everything that comes out of there is run by all the staff.
Yeah.
We like to get input from everyone so that it's not just one vision. It's a whole vision of what we all see out there. So I think that's one thing that kind of gets left behind is, you know, we want to show that it's a group effort, and a lot of our beer gets put out that way. I think a lot of exposure comes from word of mouth, and the more people educated about it. I mean, most people know us for our peanut butter stout. That's why I like to introduce our IPAs, our ales, because that's kind of what got us in the market, our peanut butter stout, amazing beer. But we do have other great beers out there, and that's kind of what we're out here to show. We're, you know, we're a great brewery, not just great stout. So,
yeah. One of the beers we had down there was the, like, maple syrup, what was it called?
Oh, yeah. It tasted like eating breakfast.
Right, yeah. And we do a lot of, like, one-off beers with, let's say, Rockstar Entertainment down there. We get D's Nuts, which is a brown hazelnut stout. And, I mean, so we do kind of some special that has to do with certain things. We actually just brewed a beer that's going to be hitting the market, very limited kegs, with Gate City, our distributor partners.
Yeah.
I mean, it's kind of something new that they were doing a backyard. They included us in it this year. And we brewed a tart saison that came out amazing. It's just something that people didn't expect coming from us. On top of that, it kind of, you know, helps us show support with our local distributors out here that we're not just about San Diego. We're, you know, trying to get out there and show, you know, a little beaver love, as we say.
Yeah, so, gotcha. Yeah. Speaking of D's Nuts.
Yeah.
There's a lot of funky names going around in Belching Beaver.
Yeah.
And one of them being the miso honey.
Oh, yeah.
That came from the Full Metal Jacket movie, right?
Full Metal. We play a lot off the movies, you know, different innuendos, stuff like that.
Yeah.
So, you know, our Here Comes Mango, our Mango IPA, is a playoff words from Blazing Saddles. So that's kind of where we got that. So we do play with a lot of that. And I mean,
so who's responsible for that?
A lot of that has to do with our brewers and we basically try to name the beers as they come off the line. So what's coming out first and fast, that's kind of what we stick to and kind of just run with it. But a lot of that comes from the brewers and our production guys. You know, they taste it, see it, and whatever comes to mind and kind of fits the beer, that's kind of what we run with. So
I like it.
Yeah, I like it actually.
And I heard somebody playing the song earlier. Was that you?
No, but it just worked out. Yeah, that was perfect. That was perfect, yeah.
I mean, you guys are distributed by Gate City, right? So what kind of coverage do you guys have?
So right now we're actually in 6 different states that we've got distribution partners with. So we're all throughout the Western region, including Hawaii.
Yeah.
So we've got, you know, Oregon, Las Vegas, Nevada, Arizona. We're actually just getting some product out to China.
We're
actually doing a festival out there with, and we've got product in Holland now. So Holland's kind of playing with our peanut butter cans out there too. So we're, you know, we're speckling out there, but at the same time, we're trying to cover where we're at to keep, you know, keep it flowing to where it's not just, you know, getting lost in the mix of things. So, we've been playing with states, but at the same time, we got to kind of stay with the growth. We can't really get outside of ourselves and then kind of lose it. So yeah, that's kind of where we're at right now.
That's pretty good, man.
You know, keeping with the West and then making sure everything's covered and slowly trickling out. Yeah.
That's pretty good for, what was it, 2011?
2012, yeah.
2012 that you guys started?
Just turned 4 this past October, so.
That's crazy, man. And we met Troy out there.
Yeah, he's the one that created the beaver's milk, which turned into the peanut butter stout.
Yeah.
And then comes the Hop Highway, which is our first IPA that was named off the 78 highway there. Vista did their 50th anniversary, and we brewed that beer to kind of collaborate with that and called it the Hop Highway IPA.
Yeah.
And it kind of stuck, and it was the original, you know, Hop Highway beer, and now that's considered the Hop Highway just because of all the brewers down there, you know. So, yeah.
Yeah, that's cool.
Got a little bit of fast history.
Troy was cool, man. He was all over it, man. It was good.
Yeah, and he's involved. I mean, he's down from the creation of the beers to the brewing to, I mean, stuff to where, you know, sometimes a brewmaster doesn't feel like he should be. He's, you know, knee-deep in stuff.
So yeah.
I like that about it. I think it just kind of shows across sales-wise when he's out there doing it, wanting to come out with us on sales runs and stuff. I mean, that's some passion behind the beer, you know. So,
for sure.
I like it.
He was busy putting new equipment. He stopped.
Yeah. I mean, he's installing it. He's troubleshooting. Yeah.
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 Yeah, that was huge down there. I know we took out some time from them, but they were amazing.
Yeah.
Completely amazing.
And that's one thing they love is seeing the support from outside areas coming down there. I mean, that's not that easy for you guys to head out, especially running a business and everything. I mean,
yeah.
So it goes both ways, I'm sure.
So lastly, what's new for Belching Beaver? What's on the horizon?
So new this year, we've actually got a pretty solid beer calendar. Kind of partnered, you know, ran it across with Gate City, and they seem like they're going to partner with us with the majority of the beers, kind of support us with, you know, back in the seasonals, which has always been a hard thing to kind of keep up with as a distributor, which we have some great seasonals coming up. I mean, it's just different beers that we've played with in the tasting room that have worked really well that we feel like the outside markets can definitely, you know, use a little introduction to. So we're going to be introducing a lot of those beers. We got some monthly one-off beers that we're going to be doing. So there's a lot of new style that it's going to introduce more of our stouts, more of our IPAs, you know, kind of a broader spectrum. On top of that, we have a whole rebrand coming this year. So our packaging rebrand. So our packaging is going to be changing. We're kind of going more of a uniform look, helping us get into the major markets. So we're going to have more, you know, chain play with the bigger stores and stuff. So it'll definitely help with exposure and, you know, stuff like that. So
there's
a lot more focus on you know, rolling out more and kind of just getting away from the stagnant. You know, we just want to keep it in perspective, especially with all the new things going on, new brewery, new tasting rooms. It's just kind of, you know, keeping it out in people's minds. And, you know,
nice. Definitely. Nice. Well, shit, we appreciate you coming out tonight, man. One more thing, though. Yep. We're going to get, Katie was in the episode last episode, so we're going to get her over here and have her talk to us about the miso. So you guys remember Katie. She's back again tonight. So how's the miso?
She's so honey.
She's so honey.
It's really good. It's super light.
Yeah.
I mean, it looks like it would almost be like the hanger orange wheat. So you go into it thinking it's going to taste orangey, and you get surprised with the honey.
Definitely.
But it's definitely lighter. It's perfect for summer. It's the perfect type of beer.
Yeah. I call it a great intro beer for the craft drinkers that are becoming craft drinkers.
Yeah.
Because they're still on that domestic edge, but that honey end kind of tells them, oh yeah, I'm getting crafty here, you know, and I can still drink it and put down another one. So it's definitely a great beer to work.
For
it
sure.
It definitely has more flavor than a regular, like a blonde, but it's not too much.
Right.
Of course, I go up to the chick and I'm like, I want a peanut butter stout. I already knew it going in there. I was like, that's why I came here.
Yeah.
And she goes, well, have you tried Beaver Le Beaver? And I was like, don't bother with me. I've got my eyes set.
Yeah.
Bo gets the Beaver Le Beaver. I take a sip of his and I was like,
That happens to me at every festival lately. I've been bringing out Viva La Beaver instead of peanut butter, and the first thing is like people get mad, you know, how can you not show up with peanut butter? And then they try that one and it's like, oh,
it's
thank you.
Because it's peanut butter with extra flavor.
It's our base. It's a peanut butter as a base, but we add Mexican chocolate, Ibarra or Abuelita, and it does the same effect as mole. It bitters up the chocolate a little bit to where it's a little more drinkable, not as sweet all the way through. So the body's a little easier to put down, but it's higher in alcohol. It's 7.5.
I think we talked about that one.
And the only reason I think we didn't follow it up right away is because it's so so similar to the peanut butter that you want to cycle them in between something else.
But
it kind of brings back the excitement on that. Yeah. Speaking of, I have a sample, so I'll leave it so you guys know what we're talking about.
Cool.
And then if we want to do something with that later, we can always do that too. Yeah. Yeah.
I'll be here for that.
Yeah, they're going to have to be here every Thursday now because these guys are asking for you.
Yeah.
Hey.
And which we're going to actually be changing the name on that a little bit. It's going from Viva La Beaver to just Mexican Chocolate Stout because there was a little confusion between that and our chata. So we want to just kind of clarify it. Yeah, yeah.
Is Bo drinking a miso? Oh, did he take off?
No, he went outside. He probably forgot to clock out.
He chased that chick out there.
Better like watch out.
Occupied with beer, and he's like, all right.
That happens.
Yeah.
That happens.
Here she is.
Here I am.
All right. So what do you think about the beer?
I have the mic up too.
You don't have the mic. You can leave it there. Just leave it there.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
I really like it. This is my
favorite. Are you like? Have you seen what's the movie?
Full Metal Jacket.
No, Ricky Bobby. You're like, I don't know what to do with my hands.
So I really like the beer. It's really good. I really like it. It's really smooth. It's really light. I like heavy beers. I like stouts. This is really good.
Yeah.
So I like their peanut butter stout a lot. But this
you
is
tried
like,
that Beaver and Beaver, right?
Yeah, that one was really good too. Cheers.
Here,
I'm out of here. I'm
trying to get a beer, but I'll cheers with an empty glass.
There we go.
What do you got?
Belching Beaver. Miso honey.
You like it?
It's good.
Yeah?
It's good. My favorite beer from Belching Beaver is definitely Viva La Beaver.
Viva La Beaver. Cesar was talking about it.
Yeah, it was their chocolate, or no, their peanut butter stout with Mexican chocolate.
Oh, gotcha.
We got it down in San Diego and went to the tap room. Yeah. By far the best one.
When we were down there, we had this one that was like a maple stout. It literally tastes like fucking pancakes and syrup. It was weird, man.
That sounds good.
Yeah, it was the weirdest shit I've ever tasted. I mean, to drink a beer and then get a hint of like maple syrup and all that shit is
trippy. It's like a dessert.
Yeah.
That sounds good. Like that peanut butter chocolate one, really good. But I could only drink like one, two of those. It's not like an all-nighter. But this one, the miso honey, pretty good. I could drink a few of these.
Yeah, a few of them. Cool, man. Well, we want to thank you guys for coming
down.
Thank you
guys. I really appreciate it.
So anyways, guys, I want to thank Cesar for coming down. Come down for Pint Night every Thursday night at the Stackz Company. We'll see you next time. Work around the clock and the life is saying, yeah, that's how I get down. Beats for your speakers, you can pop the singing Jeep, back your woofers and your tweeters. Y'all be listening to me while you pop the Jeep and Jeep.
Well, at least you didn't say your father-in-law was a douchebag.
Yeah, exactly. Well, now it's on this one.
Now it's going to be on
Sorry,
this one.
Sorry, Dad.
Oh, well.